Summit, and she will talk about urban green infrastructure.
Okay. Thank you very much, Francesco, for your invitation. It's a pleasure to be here tonight with you. Not exactly civil engineering, but also civil and environmental engineering. It's proud for me to be environmental engineering. So we speak about urban green technologies and infrastructures, which is the background, which is the main topics, you know, urban vulnerability and resilience, because in the last decades, a robust urbanization of the world occurred, so an increase in several environmental problems and issues, such as rainfall water, concentrated rainfall water event, stormy water event, and at the same time, an increasing of the water surface flow at urban level because of the impermeable surface that are present. Not only water issues, but also the so-called heat island effect, because at urban level, you know, an increase in temperature, in particular in summertime, but in particular at the urban level, and higher temperature than in the green areas in the surrounding or in the country. Then other issues, energy consumption, air pollution, biodiversity reduction, soil scarcity, and so on. Here you have some picture related with the heat island effect in London, for instance. You can see very well that in the surrounding, thanks to the thermal camera, you can see the green areas, that means a lower temperature, and runoff and rainwater issues, because in the green areas you have an higher percentage of water that is able to infiltrate in the ground, increasing groundwater, that is a good news because of the water resource availability. At the contrary, in the gray areas, you know, the 55% of the water remain on the surface and run off, with several risks about flow, about risk for buildings, and so on. So we are moving towards a future where our cities have to be more resilient. The term, the word resilience, was born both in ecology and in metals and material sciences, that means the capability to adapt, okay, without problems. And urban resilience, I like very much that picture I found on the website, because it means exactly what resilience means. The word resilience as an umbrella term for the planning and design strategies to help our cities develop the capacity to meet the challenges of the future. So, that means to find solutions towards the problems we have in face because of climate change and other issues, as I said before. And a resilient city is one that has developed capacities to absorb future shocks and stresses to its social, economic, environmental system. That is, once again, the three pillars related with sustainability, you know, not only environmental sustainability, but also economical and social. And according with the Agenda 2030 of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, the number 11 is related with sustainable cities and communities. Inside these very large goal and topic, you find all the solutions we are talking about tonight in relation with the resilience of the new cities. Sorry, what happened? Okay. And green technologies, green infrastructure can be considered as a solution for water management, for all the issues we have seen before in relation with the change we are living. Don't worry, I jump enough production and eat Island Effect. We will talk about also in the next slides. Which are urban green technologies? What about this kind of infrastructures? We are talking about some technologies, not exactly natural solution, but nature-based solution, having a technological perspective. For instance, green roofs. You have to consider that they are not exactly a green surface with some flowers and some grass, but it is a green roof is a technological solution, having the capability to collect rainfall water, to drainage rainfall water, to storage rainfall water, to absorb pollutants, to reduce thermal dispersion of the building, to guarantee a thermal insulation and so on. So we are talking about the technologies and infrastructures. Here you have some ideas, not only green roof, but for instance, green parking, green surface, wet areas, green walls and green facades. Green walls and green facades, infiltration areas, also at a very, very small level, small scale, you can improve water collection and improve water permeability of the soil, considering some small infiltration areas along the streets, in the urban park, in urban parks and gardens, and so on. We are talking also about the rain gardens, some very small solution able to absorb rainfall water and to guarantee the infiltration in the soil. Here, parking, green parking, or better, permeable parking. Another very simple solution, reducing impermeability at urban level. And urban agriculture, that is also an interesting solution on the roofs, improving sociality of our cities and so on. But talking about green roofs, here you have some picture in New York City. So New York City is also since 2000 encouraged the construction of green roofs, at least over the public buildings. And the story is a longer story. So here you have some mythos related with the Babylonia Gardens. Or in the Imperial Rome, here the Mausoleum of Augustus, the Italian Renaissance with garden at urban level. But just to show you some solutions that were developed also in the past, here you have in Iceland roof covering. In terms of thermal insulation, in this case the problem was the very low temperature in Iceland. At the contrary, in our urban, these solutions are excellent solution in terms of heat island effect, in terms of too much high temperatures. And also today, quite the same solutions after 1,000 years, some solutions thanks to important architects. The green is a tool in terms of thermal insulation of our buildings. Okay, just to joke, in Norway, this is a very... Centrally in Spain, green facades and green walls as a solution for thermal insulation, but towards high temperature, in this case, they guarantee a sort of thermal passive protection of the building. Other picture, the California Science Academy, or the Delft University Library, that is a very, very large green roof, a very large area, so where students can walk and live. Other countries, not only Europe, not only North America, but over the world, are encouraging green roofs. Here you have in India, the Green Business Center in Kondapur, Hyderabad. India is encouraging green roofs as a solution for thermal insulation of buildings. Here, Colorado. And just to show you that what I said before, that we are talking about technologies, not exactly about a green area or a green surface. Here you have a green roof that is made by several layers, having important role, you can see. Not only insulation, thanks to a layer and a waterproof membrane, but also the drainage layer, the filter layer, that are able to collect the water and to drain water towards maybe a storage system, for instance, for rainwater collection. That can be used maybe later when no rainfall water event is present. Here you have the water collection on the green roof, and thanks to the water collection, there is also a water transportation towards a storage system. Green roof can be extensive or intensive. Intensive could be seen as a sort of a garden over the roof, maybe more beautiful, but we are talking about a solution, a technical solution, an infrastructure, so the main part of the green roof over the world are extensive. And also at our laboratory, over our laboratory, sorry, at engineering school, we have a small green technological green roof, about 50 square meters. Here you have our green roof, where a weather station is present, a monitoring system about all weather conditions, about water measurement, rainfall water measurement, and runoff measure. We are able to detect any kind of information in terms of weather conditions, meteorology station, and to test all the water levels after rainwater event. And here you have the drainage system and pluvial pipe system for water collection. Our green roof, a small green roof in the right side of the picture, is close to a gray one, having the same surface area. That represents the comparison of one roof in order to detect the behavior of the green one respect to the gray one. And the information are really interesting. Here you have, for instance, a rainfall water event. In the blue line, the amount of rain during 4 or 5 hours in September. In the black line one, I'm sorry, I have no glasses, but no problem. The black one represent the runoff related with the gray roof. Thank you very much. Okay. So here you have the behavior of the gray one, here, the gray one. So when a rainfall water event occurs, immediately the runoff over the gray roof, okay? The same amount of water. At the contrary, on the green roof, the water remains for a long time and the release of water is lower than the gray one. So the gray roof behavior is a sort of sponge behavior. The water is collected, is absorbed, and the runoff is strongly reduced. That is a good news in terms of runoff at urban level that can represent a risk for flooding. Temperature and heat island effect, on our roof we have the possibility to detect the air temperature, but we have also the possibility to measure the temperature inside the building. And here the thermography over the green roof and the gray roof during a day in September last year, no matter, but on the gray roof you reach quite 50 degrees Celsius degrees. During summertime in Bologna also you can reach 70 Celsius degrees in August, for instance, while the green roof remain under 30 Celsius degrees, also in August, also in summer. In this day you can see 50 degrees over the gray roof and 25-26 degrees over the green roof. That means that the temperature is lower, and the lower temperature on the roof means also a lower temperature inside the building. So that is a good news, because the temperature is not so high thanks to the presence of a green roof over the building. The same, okay, the temperature on the gray roof and on the green roof. That's all, just to show you some ideas, to show some green technologies and infrastructures at urban level. I think that these technologies can represent an excellent answer in relation with climate change we are living in, and the problems related with climate change, and yes, and global warming in particular affecting our cities. Thank you very much.